When you think of Porsche as a brand, words like iconic and performance come to mind, but how about luxurious? I'm going to walk you through the Porsche 911, the seventh generation Porsche 911. This launches a 2012 model, and I'm going to talk about how luxurious it is. For 2012, Porsche really upped the game. Basically, there are two models, a Carrera and Carrera S. This is the Carrera S, 3.8 liter, producing 400 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 4.1 seconds. Now, I can't tell you just how fast it goes, but I will verify that it will do 160. This spoiler doesn't just look pretty, it's actually functional. At highway speeds, it goes up, and this is all part of Porsche's master plan. They test this car at over 300 kilometers an hour, and because of that testing, it assures it has zero lift, essentially negligible lift, meaning this car stays low to the ground at super high speeds. That's Porsche, that's performance, that's luxury. Porsche made a lot of styling design changes to the seventh generation 911. The car is a little bit wider. It's not necessarily longer, but the wheelbase is 4 inches longer, and what that does is makes for a much better ride. This car handles more like a grand touring coupe on the highway, which is great if you want to take long trips. And one of the design elements that I really love are the new taillights. They really look kind of mean. They're shorter, they're wider, and they're really bright, and they really add to the whole look of the car. Porsche maintains certain historic, iconic items about the Porsche 911. One of them is ignition key on the left-hand side. That's Porsche, and that's how it should be. When Porsche launched the first 911 back in the 60s, you know, they had very simple seats. Today, 18-way adjustable seats. That's luxury. As you can see from this 1964 911, Porsche was not really about luxury. They were very basic cars, just good transportation and all about performance. Today, all about luxury. The first thing you notice when you get into the new Porsche 911 is just how luxurious it is. The steering wheel, the dashboard, all the controls, everything is the highest quality. The Alcantara headliner is a really nice touch, and you really feel like you're in a luxury car, but let's be honest, Porsche is about performance, and this car just flat out performs. Before we talk about performance, let's talk about fuel economy, which doesn't sound like something Porsche is synonymous with, but you hear that? The engine is off. So pretend you're at a stoplight. This is called start-stop technology, and Porsche has it. Of course, hybrids have it, but you wouldn't expect Porsche to have it, but that helps get you an extra 1 or 2 miles per gallon. Another fuel-saving feature that the new Porsche 911 has is coast technology. Essentially, pretend you're driving a manual and you push the clutch down. The car's still in gear, but it goes down to idle speeds. That's what this car can do when it's in normal mode and if you have a PDK transmission. So essentially, the car will automatically depress the clutch and will go into this coast mode, going down to 780 RPMs, saving you another 1 or 2 miles per gallon. So there are three modes: normal, sport, and sport plus. If you put the Porsche into sport plus, you're gonna have a lot of fun. So we're gonna demonstrate launch control. What you do is you push the brake with your left foot, push the gas all the way with your right foot, and take off. That was launch control, and that is a lot of fun. It really makes an argument for why do you even need a manual transmission. But guess what? Porsche has an all-new, first-ever 7-speed manual transmission that is, quite frankly, just wonderful. Another first for Porsche in the 911 is electromechanical steering. One of the main reasons they did this was to save fuel economy. So when I'm driving on a straight road like this, I really don't need to have any steering input, so the motor's not working. But when I'm on a twisty road or if I'm gonna make a sharp turn, guess what, the motor kicks in. That motor has its own start-stop technology, and by only coming on when you make turns, it saves you miles per gallon. So there you have it, the 2012 Porsche 911. This car just keeps getting better and better. For over 45 years, they've been building dreams, and they just keep doing it. So the base price on the Carrera is $82,100, $96,400 for the Carrera S, as seen here, about $105,000. In my opinion, quite a bargain.